Hello everyone and welcome back to Teacup Tarot. Now in today's video, as usual, we are going to be looking into our weekly predictions. So we will look into the energies of the upcoming week, what is in store for you when it comes to your life, when it comes to your career, your love life, all of the things. Okay, now you have three piles in front of you. Please make sure you use your intuition when it comes to selecting the pile, and once you're done, we shall start with the very first one, which is pile one. And if you've selected pile one, this is what's coming up for you in the upcoming week. Alright then, as we start this reading, I really want to take your Moonology card first. Now, your Moonology card says, nothing will come out of the situation. So, if there is something in your life that is currently bothering you, if there is something that is really, really upsetting you in some way, or something that is giving you sleepless nights, there is a probability that nothing will come out of this situation, and you may just be overthinking things. Just remember this message, especially for the upcoming week. Okay, so don't stress yourself out, just relax and ease into this week is what I'm going to tell you. Now, what this week is also going to bring towards you is transformation. Now, this can be transformation like an internal transformation, but this can also be a transformation when it comes to outward changes. One thing that you need to be reminded of is to be open to whatever changes that are coming into your life, because there is a possibility all the changes that will now happen will be for your highest good. It is sort of happening to you to sort of push yourself out of your comfort zone slightly is what I'm getting here. Now, along with this card, what I want to remind you of is with this message of being open to change, you should this week consider alternative approaches to your situation. Now, this can be in multiple areas of your life. The smallest example I can give is if you are right now sticking to a particular exercise routine, you need to look at alternatives. Same way when it comes to your career, you know, if you're used to doing things in a certain way, try and look at alternative approaches that you can bring into the situation, because the approach that you're taking right now may need a little bit of modification. Of course, this can apply to any area of your life. If something that you're doing is not working, or something that you're doing is not really giving you, you know, the kind of result you're expecting, try alternative approaches. Okay, that's something that's really, really important here. Also, the energy of this week for you is the card of strength. So you have the capability to do anything and everything that you want to accomplish. All right. If this transformation that is coming forth for you, this is only because you're choosing for this to happen. I don't really see this as something that is happening to you, but this is something that you're consciously choosing. Either way, you're feeling very strong, you're feeling very confident, and you're very, very assertive. Also, when it comes to circumstances, you are just living your best life this week is what I'm going to really, really tell you. Now, the next one for you is, this week you also may be very focused on your work, you know, your work environment or your home environment also can be a possibility, or putting in extra effort towards making something better. Now, the Eight of Pentacles is popularly about, you know, mastering the skill, like paying attention to the smallest detail so that things end up being perfect. So like you end up becoming the master of things, you know. So this week, even if change is happening, firstly, you are in control. And the reason you're in control is because you are paying attention to even the minutest detail right now, especially if this is relating to your career. So you are really paying attention to your career very, very properly, and you really, really are very focused and, you know, very, very assertive when it comes to this week is what I'm getting here. Now, along with all that assertive energy, a lot of fire energy in fact is seen when it comes to your cards this week, okay? Very much a very, very outward energy is what I'm feeling for this week. But along with that outward energy is this beautiful sense of calmness. There is this, you know, emotional setup also coming into play. So this is the card of Six of Cups. You may also slightly feel nostalgic. This can be be you sitting with certain albums. This can be you sitting with certain elements of your past. For a couple of you, you may just have a chance conversation with a childhood friend, a friend that you've not connected before, a person who used to be a part of your life before, but who hasn't really been a part of your life for some time now. All of that is possible here. But for a couple of people, you know, this can also be you like getting rid of something from the past. You know, you paying attention to something that you haven't paid attention to for some time. Okay. So this is like even when it comes to your work area, you know, you may want to take a look at work that you have been keeping piled up for some time. Please pay attention to all of these things, because what I'm really getting here is if you keep things piled up or keep things on the back burner for too long, then, you know, you will sort of, you know, land up in a soup later on. So if there's something that needs attention, especially past elements, pay attention to it. Especially documentation is what I'm really getting for a couple of you. But again, this can also be about letting things grow from your past. You know, this can be your clothes, this can be your belongings. This is like, you know, you consciously taking things in your hands and letting certain things go. You know, a message of release is also something that I'm really getting here. You may also want to make a lot of changes when it comes to your habits this week. You may also be making a lot of changes when it comes to your career this week, okay? That is also very much possible here. Either way, you are making this happen. Nothing that is happening this week is sort of out of your control, is what I'm really getting here. Now, let us look into the rest of your cards. The next one for you is abundance. Now, this is such a beautiful card. I really like it. So, like I said, you know, firstly, money-wise, this week looks really good. But when I'm getting the Six of Cups message, it is not only about your emotions, but this can also be certain financial elements that you need to take care of. If you, you know, have to sort of put that money in when it comes to a specific deposit, don't delay it. If there are certain financial transactions that you were supposed to do a long time back, take care of it. Any pending credit card bills, please make sure you're paying attention to that, because anything that you ignore right now will sort of spiral out of control later on. So changing your approach to money is also something that I'm really getting here. Now, when it comes to your self-care, it is spending time with friends. So this week, again, with the Six of Cups, like I said, meeting somebody from your past. So this could be, you know, meeting a childhood friend, connecting with a childhood friend, and just exchanging that loving conversation is also very much possible here. Of course, you know, cleansing items from the cupboards, letting certain things go. For a couple of you, this can also be letting an old friendship go, which no longer serves you, okay? This can be a very specific message, but this is also coming into play out here. Either way, put a lot of focus when it comes to your work area and perfecting things that need perfecting, because you are very much in control. The energy is very outward. So you are feeling your best self to take care of anything that is unresolved at this point of time. Be open to change. Okay, that's something you really need to remember. Now, we will come to your lover's oracle. Yeah, let us look at the messages. Deep in your heart, you already know the answer. Do what feels right. So this week, you are being asked to trust your intuitions, and especially with the Six of Cups card, this really brings me back to the memories of an ex that you need to let go of. That is also coming through for a couple of you. But either way, if you are faced with a choice when it comes to the upcoming week, especially with the change card being there, do what you feel is right. Trust yourself. You have the strength to take any decision that is right for your life at this point of time. To trust your intuitions is what I'm going to tell you. Now, the next one is, imagine on unwanted thoughts dissolving into light, creating room for new opportunities and possibilities for your life. So, like I said, anything that does not belong in your life should be sort of shown the way out. Again, with the Six of Cups, I was telling you, you know, cleaning your cupboard, taking care of unfinished business, again, that is coming forth. But again, with the transformation part, you know, your thoughts towards love may be changing. The way you look at love can also be undergoing a lot of changes. So if there is anything that needs release from your life, you know, you should let it go, let it dissolve into a light, because what this will happen is, you know, you will sort of make, you know, that space for you, new things to come in. You know, that is something that is really indicated. So this week, I think when it comes to, you know, your love life, your love situation, it's all about connecting with yourself and sort of, you know, letting the energy of the past stay in the past, or letting go of something that no longer belongs in your life. So that is what your message is when it comes to your lover's oracle. Now we shall move on to your lucky numbers, and at the end of the reading I am also going to take some cards from your sea melodies, and we'll also see what messages are in store for you from there. That will be at the very end. Okay, few more. So the numbers for you, 55, again an angel number, number 4, number 7, number 5, and number 16. I'm going to give you a couple. 17. Remember, this is like a timeless reading, so whenever you find this, it's right for you. Alright, so you have 55, 4, 5, 7, 1, 18, 16 and 17. Now, my favorite part of the entire reading, we are going to be looking into 11. Okay. You have the letter N. You have a blank tile, so you can really use it to fill in the letters that are absent, you know, that will sort of help you make that entire word. And let me know if you find your name in this, because some people actually end up finding their names. So yeah, A and I and E. Oh, I found one. You have ring. Commitment, a deeper commitment for with somebody from the past, or just doing what is right. Are you getting a proposal this week? I wonder. Let me know if that happens, okay? So I get the letter ring. Is there anything else? You have rang as well. So a telephone call. Are you getting a telephone call this week? Something that will sort of transform a lot of things, change a lot of things. All of that is possible. Or a telephone call from a friend. Why don't you make the call? You know, just connect with your friends this week. So that is also there. There is a tie. Are you going for an interview? Or just tying up the loose ends? You know, that is what I was talking about. So even that is possible. Okay, so I'll just let you guys form the rest of, you know, the words. Let me know in the comment section, because I really, really look forward to it. Now, what I'm going to do is I am going to give you this extra oracle just to wrap things up, because I've really gotten into this practice in my own spiritual practice where I sort of pick a card for myself and see where it goes. Your message is optimism. After each rainstorm, there will be clear skies. Again, transformation, especially if things were not working out for you. The future looks optimistic, and especially since you have the strength card, you know. So especially for this week, I think things are really, really looking good for you. You are finding your element. You are letting certain energies of the past go. And again, with the abundance, I think the future is really, really, really optimistic for you. See, nothing will come out of the situation, so there is nothing that you need to ever worry about. Okay. Oh, and I missed one. It's Z. Oh, thank God I sort of found that one at the right point of time, because otherwise, you know, it keeps you wondering. I know, because it really irritates me when something like that happens. Oh, it's a zing as well. How many of you have seen Hotel Transylvania? You know, you had that she is my zing thing. So again, it can be that as well. Either way, I will leave you to this. I wish you guys a beautiful, brilliant and joyful, abundant week ahead. Enjoy yourself. I will see you in my next one. Bye. And if you've selected pile 2, this is what the week ahead holds in store for you. Alright then, we shall start with the very, very first card, and we'll talk about the tarot first. Now, This week, I just feel like overall you are in a very reflective mood, you are in a very planning kind of a mood. Either way, you are in a very, very balanced state of mind, you know. It's almost like you are like the hermit, like you want to sort of go within and explore a different dimension is what I'm really getting here. You may also want to reassess a lot of things, reassess the way you are doing things, the way you are operating in general is what I'm really getting here. But along with that, it is like, you know, you are looking to the future and wondering if the path that you're walking on right now is the right thing for you, or you may want to make a couple of adjustments. And this is exactly why you are slowing down slightly this week. Just take a look at this little cat, you know. The hermit is out there meditating and you have this little cat meditating in her own way. So we all have our own ways when it comes to self-reflection, and you are this week doing exactly that. Now, if I take a look at your oracle card, this says your path, you know, have the courage to follow your own path. And that's exactly what you're doing. You are now wondering what the right path for you is. And I think the best way to discover this is just to take that calm and quiet time. But the way you are taking this calm and quiet time is you are just taking that step back. I believe you are also taking that step back because you think you deserve to do it. Just look at this card. Like, this is one of my ultimate favorite cards when it comes to the entire tarot deck, you know. Here she is just reading a book under a beautiful tree. You have like apples, oranges, and you have like chocolates and wine, and she is just living her best life. And the reason she's living her best life is because she has earned it. Like, I believe already in your life you may be at a very, very good situation. You have worked very hard and you are sort of gaining the rewards of that hard work as well. And there is a possibility, like financially as well, you could get a significant amount this week, or you may realize that you are very, very blessed in terms of your life. Okay, you may be able to live your life in a way that not many people are able to. Yeah, so along with that, you have this moonology card which says prosperity lies ahead. So this makes me wonder if you are actually also planning in terms of your life, you know, planning as to what to do with your money, what to do with the rest of your career, whether your approach is correct, how do you want to go about things, all of that. Either way, let me tell you, money wise as well, the week looks ahead, but I believe you also need to work towards a certain bit of financial planning, especially for your future. Okay, if you are blessed right now, make sure you are preparing for the future. And along with this card, which tells you to sort of strategize, so maybe this week you need to sit down with abundance planning, you need to sit down with your life planning, or with your career planning, with certain documents is what I'm getting here, like fixing certain things, you know, like signing any new contracts, all of that is coming forth, because you also have the Queen of Pentacles. Now, the Queen of Pentacles is like a very home-based being, but she's also capable of taking care of her career. So this is truly, in the right sense of the word, a balanced week for you. All right, but again, with the Queen of Pentacles, she's really, really resourceful when it comes to her resources. So the proper utilization of the resources that you have right now may also be on your mind. So maybe that is something you're strategizing about. When it comes to your career, I really see you sort of, you know, looking into what you want to do sort of, you know, 2 years down the line, 4 years down the line, 5 years down the line. So that is what I'm seeing. For a couple of you, what I'm also getting here is you are now deciding whether the path you are walking on is the right kind of path to you. For a couple of you, especially for those who want to shift your careers or make certain decisions when it comes to your career, do something that really, really speaks to you. Or you may receive guidance from a female about what the right choice to make is when it comes to your life and your circumstances. But either way, I suggest really take that time in the upcoming week to ask yourself whether you are happy with your current circumstances. Because anytime the hermit shows into a situation, I always want to take a step back and, you know, do some proper research about my life, where I am in my life and my circumstances. Okay, that is what I'm getting for you in the upcoming week. Now let us look into the rest of your cards. Now when it comes to your very first one, you have domestic harmony. So not only when it comes to your specific life, you know, financial life, career life, but even when it comes to your personal life, things are beginning to look really, really good. Again, with the Queen of Pentacles energy, very balanced, knows exactly what to do in what circumstances, and with the Nine of Pentacles, I just feel like you are in a place where you need to count your blessings, and maybe that's exactly what you're doing sitting under this beautiful tree. Okay, that's what I'm really getting here. Now when it comes to your self-care, aromatherapy, I really, really feel you are in the self-care zone. You know where you're at and you know where you're heading, or maybe you're asking yourself, am I doing the right thing? But either way, you are in control and very, very emotionally stable and in a good place for the upcoming week is what I see. Of course, aromatherapy is my absolute favorite. My favorite fragrances are sandalwood and lavender. So if they speak to you, then you should really, really try them out, because they really alter your state of mind and really help you calm down. Okay, that's something I really want to tell you. If you guys are into aromatherapy, I would love to know what scents you suggest, because I am open to trying anything new that you're suggesting me. Yeah, that's what I'm getting at. Now, we will take up the Lover's Oracle to see what romantic messages you are getting here. First one, surrender. At times, we must surrender the old before something new can enter our lives. Let go and all will work out. Classic, classic hermit card. Surrender. Take that step back. Just focus on yourself this week, you know, because the focus is on nothing else but you and your own personal life and your own personal choices. And that is sort of when it comes to your romantic life as well. If things are sort of, you know, in a state of flux, or things are a little bit unsure, just surrender them. But either way, you know, because you have the domestic harmony card as well, the more you surrender, the more things will work out for you is what I'm really, really getting here. Now let's go to the next one. Now, it is important right now to take a step back and spend some time alone. Instead of placing your focus on another, now is the time to give yourself. Again, indeed, this sort of, your tarot card setup is personifying your reading. This week is all about you. So focus on yourself, focus on giving yourself what you need. Self-care again with the aromatherapy is very, very important, because you know this is a week where you need to fill your own cup and then sort of look into the energies of another is what I'm really getting here. Now, what I'm going to do is I am going to be giving you your numbers, which will sort of help you make the choices. Or you know, this can be your numbers, this can be your birth dates, any important dates that are coming up, all of that is possible. You have number 6, can be 9 as well. And you have 26, number 8, 55, again an angel number, number 5. 88, abundance as well. So money wise as well, you know, with the Nine of Pentacles, things are really, really looking good. And you have number 19. So those are your numbers. Let us look into my favorite part, which are the letters. Okay, let's see what we get. Oh, either way, you have a repeating letter E. So E and E. And you have an X, X, energy of an X. Okay, A, X. Anything that you feel doesn't belong in your life, it's time to let it go. Pay attention to yourself is what I'm going to tell you this week. Okay, so yeah. And I again, okay, double letters. A, B, and you have E again. Okay, so those are overall your letters. If there's something you can find, then please let me know in the comment section down below. I always, always, always read your comments, yeah? And I'm gonna give you one card again. Like I was telling you, I'm gonna wrap it up with a card here, because I'm really getting into this practice, you know, and it's really, really helping me out. So I hope it helps you as well. Let's see what guidance we are gonna get today. Okay, I'm gonna take this one. Empathy. There's more beneath the surface. Alright, so your card for this week is empathy. Be sensitive to other people as well as sensitive you are being to yourself and your own moods, okay? So empathy for yourself is also very, very important at some time, you know? So don't ever feel bad about taking care of yourself. That's something I really, really want to highlight here, because what happens is, especially for us women, you know, whenever we take that self-care break, we always feel guilty. Like, we are not taking care of this, we are not taking care of that. No need to feel guilty at all. Okay, that empathy has to be for other person, but that has to be for your own self. Like, feeling your own feelings in a third person is also something that I'm really getting here. Alright, so, oh, you have win. What are you winning? Oh, you have wine as well. Oh, look at that, you had a wine here. So, well, I'm not going to say anything else, okay? So I think the message is very, very, very clear. Yeah. So I think even your letters want you to take that little bit of break. So, well, what can I say? I'm going to leave you with here, because I can just talk and talk and talk till the end of the world. I love it. And yeah, that's also my job. So yeah, I'm going to leave it here and I'll see you in my next one. Have a beautiful week ahead. Bye-bye. And if you've selected pile 3, then this is what's in store for you for the upcoming week. Alright then, what we are going to be starting off with, we are going to be starting off with this card. Now this says, look beyond what you see. And I think that's so very important, because this week what I feel is, you know, you need to look beyond your current circumstances. You really, really need to reflect deep within yourself, because there are some things that are happening to you this week that needs to be examined from a third person's point of view, is something that I'm really getting here. Because what's happening is, you have the Five of Pentacles, okay? Now the Five of Pentacles is about really feeling bad about something. This is, in fact, you know, a card which tells you, like, you may actually have everything, but you still feel like something is missing. But what's important here, if you see, you know, you have this woman carrying this lamp and she's like searching for something, but she is searching for something in the wrong direction, because if she just looks at her left, there is actually a beautiful place where she and this little child can actually seek shelter, you know. So this woman is sort of just looking at problems. She is not focusing on the solution which is close at hand, okay? So this week, I really, really want you to dig deeper, because there are certain things, certain blessings in your life that are very easy to miss for you this week. So this week, please look beyond what you see, because your awareness has to change and the way you are looking at your current circumstances need to change tremendously. Also, what is happening for you this week is, you know, you have already accomplished a lot. Like, even when it comes to money, even when it comes to your circumstances, you are in a good place. But maybe there is something that is triggering you, or something that is happening to you, which is sort of causing you a little bit of discomfort. But remind yourself, this is just an illusion. Whatever phase you find yourself at this point of time, if you just shift your perspective, your life will change, is what I'm really getting here. Because what I also have here, you know, you have the World card. So you have a world of opportunities available to you. Also, this is a very, very good week to start looking at alternative solutions to your problems, is what is coming here. Also, what you need to do this week, you know, especially, just move beyond your current circumstances. Move beyond your comfort zone is also what is coming here. What you need to remember is, there is a new start coming, which is what I was highlighting. You know, the possibilities that are available for you for your life are endless. Of course, with the new start coming, there can be a shift in perspective eventually, and then that new start will come. What is most important is your perspective when it comes to this upcoming week. Also, because of this new, you know, circumstance, this Ace of Pentacles, this can be the beginning of a new habit. This can be beginning of a new job, beginning of a new career, because the World can also signify the end of something and beginning of something. But you need to sort of put the past where it belongs, in the past, and look towards your life from a fresh fresh set of eyes with a fresh set of eyes is what I'm getting here. Also, this can be a good week to sort of make some new plans is also what is coming here. For a couple of you guys, you know, if you have been wanting to start a new business, this may be a great week. This is a good week to sort of, you know, move beyond your boundaries is also what I'm getting here. Again, travel relating to work is also possible because the world is also a card of travel. So you may also be traveling this week. For a couple of you, I'm also getting like a change of residence. If that is something you've wanted, that is also very much a possibility. A shift of working place is also a possibility when it comes to the upcoming week. If there is somebody out there who is waiting for that job letter, that confirmation, all of that is also possible for you this week. Okay, so just be a little bit more positive about your circumstances. That is very, very important because honestly, everything in your life is fine. Also, this may be a good week to sort of, you know, start looking for new opportunities is also what I'm getting here. If there is something that you've been wanting to do for a very long time, something creative, starting a new course, you know, applying for universities, all of that can be a really, really good thing to do, especially this week. In fact, for a couple of you, you know, if you guys have been wanting to shift to a new place, this can be university, this can be a new place of work, laying the foundation for that is, you know, something that is really indicated for this week. And any new thing that you begin this week will really, really put you 10 steps forward when it comes to your life is what is coming here very strongly. Also, if there is somebody out here who has been offered a job from a new location, a new place, or you have been considering a university that is away from your workplace or away from the place of your residence, you should go for it. All right. And again, if there is somebody who's been wanting to move to a different location, move to a different country, then please start that application process or please start the process in that direction, because, you know, even that will sort of help you a lot in the upcoming weeks is what is coming through very, very strongly. Now, let us look into your next one. Patience. You need a little bit of patience this week. Patience with your circumstances is also possible here. Again, let me remind you, when, you know, some things happen in life where we feel like, you know, things are not going our way, there is always something different that you can do. Because if you look at this card, you know, this person is just sitting out here on this little bit of a desk here, and this little cat just sees the window. Like, this can be a window of opportunity for possibly for this person. He's looking at the closed door and he just feels like there is no way out for him, but this cat knows better. So be like the cat this week. Okay, little bit of patience, looking at your circumstances slightly can, you know, really help you a lot this week is what I'm getting here. Self-care. Clean your space. Okay, so I think this is like a brilliant card to come up, because I'll tell you about me, anytime I feel like I'm unhappy or some things are not working, I usually clean the space around me. I sage things out. I like change my wardrobe is also something that I do, you know, like position of things that I keep in the wardrobe. I just change things. What happens is, as you change things around you, something as simple as cleaning your closet, something as simple as cleaning your kitchen, changing your curtains, that shifts your mindset. So if you are like me, then maybe cleaning your space is something you can do, because negative energy also tends to affect our emotions a lot. Okay, we shall take your lover's oracle for this week and let us look into what the first message says. It says, close your eyes and tell yourself that you deserve to feel joyful. You can allow joy into your life regardless of the circumstances you find yourself in. Again, you know, just change your perspective a little bit, because you always can feel joyful. You know, feeling happy, feeling joyful is a choice that you need to make. You need to count your blessings this week is something that I'm really getting here, even when it comes to your lover's oracle. So there are a lot of beautiful things in your life if you just change the way you look at things is what I'm getting here. Now let us look at the next one. time. You are trying too hard. Give it time. So just give yourself a break this week is what I'll tell you, you know, because I just feel like you're stressing over things unnecessarily this week. Okay, so quit trying too hard, because you know, things happen in life, and sometimes when we feel like, you know, okay, the way we are looking at things may not be the right way to do it, or you just aren't feeling happy, take a deep breath, tune in within you and tell yourself that you deserve to feel happy, you deserve all the good things in your life, and eventually you will sort of get into the vibration that you will completely agree that good things are actually a part of your life. All right, now what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna shuffle this one card that I'm gonna be giving you, and we'll just see what message that brings for you. So that will sort of, you know, clarify a lot of things is what I'm getting here. Okay. See, this is exactly why I don't shuffle on camera, because I'm so clumsy with the cards. So, okay. Oh, we are going to take this one. Ambition. Set your sights beyond the horizon. I think this is perfect. So for you, it is important to sort of set your sights beyond the present moment. I think everything, every message that you've gotten so far has spoken about it. And you know, even this says that look beyond your current circumstances. So that's exactly what you need to see. You need to pay attention to what new things that you can invite in your life, rather than just focusing on the now, you know. So I'll really tell you, change your vibration, tune into that higher self and tell yourself that there are beautiful things in my life and I am going to be focusing on only that. Okay, so set your sights beyond the current moment is what I'm getting here, which was your first message as well. Look beyond what you see. All right, so I think it's a repeated message. So that is something you really need to remind yourself of. Now, we will come to your numbers. What are your numbers for this week? Okay. I'm going to give you one more because one just fell off. So you have number 3, number 9, a completion again with the world card, and 19, 15, 23, 16, 18. Remember, again 88, which is again a number of abundance, so financially as well. It's just you need to change your perspective. Okay, you are already blessed, your life is already best. So count your blessings this week anytime you feel slightly not happy. Yeah, either way, those are your numbers for this week. I'm going to give you letters and let's see what's coming through with them. What do we have here? A, and again you have an A. E, K. Oh, you have IKEA. How funny. So do you want to go shopping? That might be a good idea. So yeah, maybe you guys are going shopping this week for furniture. Again, with the new house that I spoke about, even that is possible, okay? I never ever thought I'll get IKEA in one of our readings here. S A R N F L N X. All right, so those are your letters. Let us see if there's something that I am getting. Oh, you have ran as well. Again, anytime you are not feeling so great, go for a run. You know, that really shifts your outlook towards things. Again, you have a fan. So you have a fan. What else? Anyway, I'm just going to leave it to you. All right. So yeah, maybe some of you are going shopping this week. Some of you may want to start something new is coming. So start a new exercise routine can also be possible for a couple of you. And yeah, I hope you guys have a good week. Shift your perspective. Okay. Shift your perspective. Be positive. Your life is great. Everything is fine. Stop worrying yourself unnecessarily. All right. So that is what I'm getting here for your upcoming week. I am getting the name Sia. Okay, so this year. All right, and yes, I will see you then in my next reading. Have a beautiful week. Take care of yourself and clean your space. Okay, as soon as you're done watching this video, the first thing I want you to do is clean your space. That'll really, really help you and put you guys in a better mood. I'll see you in my next one. Bye.